Good morning. Good morning. We'll be using Start of Work Prime, page 240 and 241. Third and fourth grade will be singing during the service. We'll be collecting and passing the plates for our mission offerings. But we'll start with page 240. We are all here, correct? For the most part, okay. Please stand. Hasten to save me, O God. O Lord, come quickly to help me. The Mighty One, God the Lord, speaks and summons the earth from the rising of the sun to where it sets. From Zion, perfect in beauty, God shines forth. God says, call upon me in the day of trouble. I will deliver you, and you will honor me. Let us pray. We give thanks, O Lord, for the rest of the past night and for the gift of a new day with its opportunities for pleasing you. Grant that we may pass its hours in the freedom of your service, and when evening comes, give you thanks again. Amen. Please be seated. Our third and fourth graders, if you are ready, and you are, will be singing hymn 527. 527. I invite all of us to open to hymn 527 right now. They'll sing the first two stanzas, stanzas one and two, and then we'll all be invited to join along with them in stanza three. 527. 527. Third and fourth grade will sing stanzas one and two, and we'll join them with stanza three.
Thank you.
Thank you, third and fourth grade. And they'll be singing on Sunday that wonderful tune and those wonderful words. Luke chapter 17 is our devotion. Now, on Jesus' way to Jerusalem, Jesus traveled along the border between Samaria and Galilee. As he was going into a village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. They stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." When he saw them, he said, "Go, show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were cleansed. One of them, when he saw he was healed, came back, praising God in a loud voice. He threw himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him, and he was a Samaritan. Jesus asked, "Were not all 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? Was no one found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" And then he said to him, "Rise and go, your faith has made you well." In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Should Thanksgiving be work? It probably feels like work to you, because when someone gives you something, you are often reminded by your mom or dad, maybe a teacher, that you should say thank you. And then you go, "Thank you." And do you mean it? Not really. Maybe you do, I don't know. I guess it depends on what it is. But even if it's something that you really wanted, like a Red Ryder BB gun, or an authentic Green Bay Packers football, or whatever, and you're really excited, and you say, "Thank you," what do you do in the next moment after you say thank you, even though you really mean it? Do you fall at the feet of the person who gave it to you, like your grandma, or your dad, your mom, and hug their feet, having dropped the Red Ryder BB gun or the football on the ground, and you're instead hugging the feet of the person who gave it to you? Has that ever happened? Nope. I mean, who knows, maybe, but not with us, not me, not you. But that's what we're talking about here, and much more importantly, in Luke 17. Sometimes this 10 lepers text is kind of used in kind of a straightforward way, where it's kind of like, say thank you, like that Samaritan leper. Say thank you, and kind of in a scoldy way. And maybe you need to be scolded once in a while, because maybe you're sort of ungrateful, and you don't feel like saying thank you, and you feel like it's just a lot of work. But why did that leper fall at Jesus' feet and worship him? He didn't really, in a way, care that he had been cured of leprosy. I mean, that was a huge thing. Life on earth had been miserable and awful. He had been cut off from all of his friends and family, and all he had was his fellow pack of lepers, who were all probably miserable too. And now that was all done. He was clean, and he could go back to living again. And not just that, at the very end, "Your faith has made you well." He didn't just mean the skin and the leprosy and everything. He means body and soul. His sins were forgiven. "That's why you can rise and go," Jesus said to that man. And I wonder if he did it. I mean, we don't know. Did he rise and go back home to let his family know that he was okay? Man, what a great homecoming that would have been. All the crying and weeping and hugging, because they could hug him again. Because you weren't supposed to hug or even get close to a leper. But now they could. Their son, their maybe husband, their brother, their dad maybe, was basically brought back to life. Great Thanksgiving. And it wasn't done like in a grudging way. They would have really, and this was a life-changing event. You maybe think, "Oh, I've never had anything like that happen to me. No one's ever cured like a cancer from me, or leprosy, or some other terrible disease," but you have been washed of all your sin, made clean forever in the blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ. Right here is maybe where it happened. Maybe in a hospital or in a home, or maybe right here. And for that, we give thanks to Jesus and we bow down at his feet every day. You know, people used to bow down at church. It's kind of funny. They would actually bow down. They would get on their knees and they would give thanks to Jesus for the great things he had done. You might think, well, that's kind of weird because Jesus isn't here. But he is, isn't he? He is right here. You can't see him, but he is here because we have his holy word and you have his holy promise that you are his dear child. And no matter where you come from, whether you're a Jew or a Samaritan or a Gentile, like most of us, we belong to Jesus, and that is the gift that will always give us life and fill us with gratitude and joy. Not because we have to. Thank you, Jesus. Thanks for washing away my sin. Although we kind of act that way sometimes. Grown-ups too. But to fill us not just with a specific feeling, but with the knowledge and the comfort that never goes away, that you belong to Jesus. And one other thing, those 9 other lepers, you know, they went to church. They went and showed themselves to the priests, and the priests were at the temple in Jerusalem, which was the church at that time. And that's where they went. I have no doubt of that. I'm sure they followed Jesus' instructions to the letter. Remember what I said at the beginning? Have you ever been given like the greatest present ever? And then thrown it aside and then grabbed on and hugged the person who gave it to you? Again, maybe. Did anyone slightly indicate they might have done that at some point in their life? Maybe, maybe not. But that's what that Samaritan leper did. Again, he didn't really care the fact that he was alive again because of his flesh being healed. What he cared about is that he knew that the man standing in front of him is the living God in the flesh, truly human, true God, and he was standing right in front of him. What else can you do but get on your knees and worship at his feet? That is the only logical, reasonable thing to do. And that's what he did. Let us join him. Let us join him in that wonderful, freely given gratitude, because we're alive. We're alive again when once we were dead, but all because of Jesus, we have been saved and made well. And that means we can rise and go and serve God with gratitude and joy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. At this time, let's have the ushers pass the plates for the offering. I'll give them to you. And what I'd like to do is to sing hymn 951 while we're doing that. 951, it's almost in the very back of the hymnal. But I think it might be a little familiar to you, especially if even you're a little older. It's a hymn that was often sung pretty much, I don't know, every Sunday almost. 951. It's a really beautiful little hymn. Lord, now you let your servant. Lord, now you let your servant depart in peace according to your word. Hymn 951. All right, 951. And join me in singing. If you know it, join along. If not, just listen along. That's fine. Lord, now you let your servant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, a light to lighten the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel. 241. Turn to page 241, please. And in just a minute, we'll have the ushers bring the offering forward. But right now, let's have everyone stand and we'll say the creed together. We join to confess the creed that I hope you get to say every day with your family. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Heavenly Father, in you we live and move and have our being. We humbly pray that you would so guide and govern us by your Holy Spirit, that in all the cares and occupations of our life, we may not forget you, but remember that we are ever walking in your sight. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Let us praise the Lord. Thanks be to God. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. Right. Mr. Raddatz. Happy blue and white day. Who's going to skit night tonight? Quite a few of you. Excellent. Excellent. Who's been to skit night in the past? Some of you have. Okay. And if you've been there before, did you have a good time? All right. You did. Excellent. Mr. Raddatz.
Did you want to sing hymn 695?
No, we'll just go. We'll just keep going.
Okay. Sounds good. Good morning. So when we miss a Friday, apparently everyone has birthdays. So there's quite a lot on here. But before we get to that, today, let's see. I'm trying to see if she's here or not. Is Mrs. Aki here or no? Not yet? Okay. Well, today we are going to say a quick little goodbye to a teacher in the first grade room. So Mrs. Zellner, could you stand up, please? Thank you. Mrs. Zellner has been serving in the first grade classroom for 6 whole weeks while Mrs. Aki was out on maternity leave taking care of Levi. And Mrs. Zellner also served last year for like 9 or 10 weeks or something like that with the same students. So we thank you, Mrs. Zellner, for your dedication and hard work with those first graders. Can we give her a little round of applause? Now, I did say it was a quick goodbye because Mrs. Zellner is also going to serve as a substitute teacher for us throughout the whole year. And it just so happens, I think she'll be in the fourth grade room next week. So, we'll see her around a whole bunch. And you'll see her for Lutheran Girl Pioneers, too, if you're in that, too. So, thank you again, Mrs. Zellner. And then, if Mrs. Aki was here, I'd welcome her back. But you'll see her around very soon. She'll be back here on Monday as well. Birthdays. Here we go. Let's see, what's the last one? Olivia, Luna, I think you are the last birthday I had. Is that right, Olivia? Okay, so Olivia got her book ready. And I'm going to ask you today, you got to hold your applause because I have a lot of names to read off, okay? So here we go. Birthday time, even from September 24th. Here we go. September 24th was Brennan Radke. September 25th was Ava Presto. Another September 25th, Cade Lidke. September 27th was Aaliyah Brockway. I don't know why I had trouble saying your name right there, Aaliyah. September 27th, man, we have a lot of double birthdays. Declan Winkler. September 29th was Logan Ziegler. Another September 29th, Nicholas Klasky. September 30th, Evelyn Atchison. Another September 30th, Greta Zick. See, look at all those double birthdays in there. It's crazy. October 1st, Madeline Brown. October 2nd, Bradley Hansen. October 3rd, Finnegan Burke. October 5th, Leo Kloss. Another October 5th was Zoe Presto. And that's where we'll leave it for now. Happy birthday. So if that big bunch could join me in my office for a birthday book, that would be great. The rest of you have a wonderful rest of your blue and white day and a Friday.
We'll see you around.
One more thing.
LGP is next Tuesday. Girls, don't forget about that. Starts at 6 o'clock. Also, guys, at the same time, Boys Club is having game night. Bring your own game. If you don't have a game to bring, just bring yourself. That starts at the same time. And then older kids, the Wells Teen Night is coming up. You haven't signed up for that. I believe eighth graders, you should take a look at that and come and join us on October 15th. Thanks very much. Have a great blue and white day.